The same communities who are dealing with the climate injustices are the same communities that are dealing with voter suppression. We're talking about African American communities. We're talking about Latinx communities. We're talking about indigenous brothers and sisters. We're talking about communities like Port Arthur, Texas, that has been dealing with the impacts from hurricanes and the pollution coming out of plants as polling stations close. When you roll back basic air protections, when you hear us say, I can't breathe, that's real. We know that disproportionately, it is our communities where these toxic facilities are being located that are literally suffocating us. And when you also allow the planet to continue to warm up and allow this pollution to circulate across our planet, you are literally shortening our lives and also taking away our ability to engage in the civic process. And for those of us who are environmental justice and climate justice advocates, we understand to protect our communities long-term, we must also protect democracy. We're training poll workers. We're helping folks to understand where their polling locations are and what the requirements are. And we are also ready on November the 4th to ensure that all votes have been counted. This is our time. We are coming down to the finish line and we have to come out in record numbers. And then, no matter the outcome, we have to rise up. On the reservation, in the barrios, in the hood, in the suburbs, all of us coming together to protect our democracy, to protect our most vulnerable communities, protecting a just transition to a clean economy, and of course, to protect our planet. The fate of our fragile democracy is in our hands.